It's time for another WrestlePlanet news update as we look at a potential AEW Ring of Honor cross-promotion show. A WWE Universal title match has been added to the Royal Rumble event, and the Forbidden Door looks set to open at the Royal Rumble. And before we continue, make sure you drop a like on the video and subscribe so you don't miss out on the latest wrestling news. And first up, due to some unforeseen circumstances, we are a little bit behind on the news. So let's bring you some of the top stories from the past few days before we get into the latest news. So let's quickly look at a new trademark filed by All Elite Wrestling, which seemingly reveals the name of the former Undisputed Era trio. AEW recently applied for the trademark for the name Paragon, along with a logo, which has led many to assume that this will be the name of Adam Cole, Bobby Fish, and Kyle O'Reilly collectively. O'Reilly would recently use the word Paragon in a recent promo, which seems to be a strong indication that this is how the three men will be known going forward. Elsewhere this weekend, Impact would hold their hard-to-kill pay-per-view, which saw an attack by a rival promotion. Ring of Honor stars Matt Haven, Vincent, Mike Bennett, and PCO would show up to attack Heath, Rhino, Willie Mack, and Rich Swann, which commentary insinuated was an invasion by Ring of Honor. The four men were accompanied by Bennett's wife Maria Canales, with it now being assumed that they will be a part of Ring of Honor's plans upon the company's return from their hiatus later this year. Not only that, but it seems Impact and Ring of Honor will be seeing more crossovers going forward. And for our last piece of news from the weekend, it was revealed that Impact Wrestling's Mickie James is set to appear in the upcoming WWE Royal Rumble match. James was released by WWE in April 2021 before joining Impact in July, going on to win the Knockouts title at Bound for Glory in October. Impact president Scott D'Amore would speak to the company's official website this week and would speak of the various promotions that they've worked with over the past year, and he would say, WWE wanted it, Mickey wanted it, and Impact Wrestling's philosophy is always to work with other major promotions to create buzz for fans. Everything is signed and agreed with WWE and Impact Wrestling. The only question is whether or not Mickey will enter one of WWE's most historic annual matches as the reigning Knockouts World Champion. There's never been a time like this for wrestling fans. In a 12-month period, Impact Wrestling has worked with NWA, AAA, New Japan, AEW, and now WWE. Impact Wrestling is the nexus of the Forbidden Door era. Mickie James successfully defended her title this past weekend at Hard to Kill, meaning she could well be heading back to WWE as the reigning Knockouts champion, which I believe would be a first time in history that a current Impact champion has wrestled in WWE. This week, a certain AEW wrestler has revealed that they could be set to appear on a hit television show. The currently absent Marco Stunt would take to Twitter to share that he is currently in the process of appearing on singing competition The Voice, with a new season set to air on NBC, and Marco would say, "Just sent in my stuff for this round of The Voice. Could take a couple of weeks to hear back, but I'm excited to be taking this journey, and I'm excited to keep you guys updated. Things have been weird lately, but seeing you all support me, regardless of what's going on, is amazing." The US version of the show is currently 21 seasons deep, with the next installment set to start in the coming months. Stunt does have a history in music, having showed off his skills as a singer-songwriter on an episode of AEW Dark during a segment with Britt Baker, as well as performing on GCW's recent Emo Night show. Stunt also has a number of old YouTube videos up of him singing under his real name, with him now looking to take his music career another step further. Next, let's go to a story regarding the NXT creative team, which has undergone internal change. According to PW Insider, the NXT creative team will not be operating independently, with it instead being run past WWE higher-ups Bruce Pritchard and Christine Lebrano. The team must now report directly to Pritchard and Lebrano to match that of both Raw and SmackDown. In the past, NXT has been kept separate from the main roster creative umbrella, instead being its own entity. However, in recent months, we have seen Triple H's NXT staff slowly but surely being let go. PW Insider also confirmed that going forward, Johnny Russo will be the head of the writing team under the supervision of Bruce and Christine. Russo would join WWE in October 2011 and worked on the main roster as part of the creative team before being promoted to a senior role in 2018. He has since worked on the NXT team since August 2019, shortly before the move to the USA Network. It's worth noting that Russo is not a relative of Vince Russo before you get down in the comments, although that would have been hilarious. It was also noted that Mick Foley's son Dewey will remain on the NXT creative team and has been overseeing 205 Live as of late. Next up, let's go to a story of a recent video that has emerged of an AEW wrestler enjoying himself in an adult establishment. A video posted to social media shows Hook laying on a table whilst being entertained by a lady, surrounded by drinks and money, and he seems to be having a good time. Okay, I'm just trying to keep this video monetized. Whilst there's not much else to say about the incident, it seems that Hook is enjoying his recent influx of merchandise money that has seen him rise to become one of the company's top sellers. And he is now officially making it rain. If AEW don't add dollars falling from the sky during his entrance, they've definitely missed a trick, as it now seems much more fitting for Hook than it does the Young Bucks. But what do you think of the recent Hook video? Let me know in the comments down below. Last week, former Ring of Honor owner Kari Silken was spotted backstage at AEW Dynamite, leaving to many to speculate that the two companies could be working together in the future. Kari, who now acts as a Ring of Honor ambassador, appeared on the Wrestling Inc. Daily podcast this week to discuss his time at Dynamite and revealed that he did in fact propose the idea of a Ring of Honor AEW joint show once the promotion returns to action in April, and he would say, "I leaned into Tony Khan and said, do you think we could maybe work with yourself if we do a show, whenever that may be? Do you know what his answer was? Here's an exclusive for you. He didn't say yes, he didn't say no. He just said, have them give me a call. So if there's a show, that would be nice." Ring of Honor is currently on hiatus, with the last show being held in December 2021. ROH Final Battle would see three current AEW wrestlers appear, with FTR and Jay Lethal being present on the show, showing that they are willing to work together if the circumstances are right. There was also several video messages saying goodbye to Ring of Honor as we knew it from former talent, including CM Punk and Bryan Danielson, who of course now work with AEW. Ring of Honor will begin holding shows once again in April 2022, and with AEW having many former Ring of Honor champions under contract, that could be a big crossover that would help ROH get back on their feet upon their return. And before we get to some news on the Royal Rumble match itself, let's get to an announcement regarding the Universal Championship at the Royal Rumble event. Roman Reigns is now set to take on his former Shield brother, Seth Rollins, at the show, a match that was made official on last night's episode of Monday Night Raw. After the announcement, Rollins would go on to defeat WWE Champion Big E to establish himself as a top contender. Roman and Seth haven't wrestled since October 2019 on an episode of SmackDown, with this being the first time that they have fought over the Universal title. The match now joins the WWE Championship match on the card, which is set to see champion Brock Lesnar defend against fellow MMA fighter Bobby Lashley, as we head towards the inevitable WrestleMania showdown between Lesnar and Reigns. And finally, following the news that Impact Wrestling's Mickie James is set to appear in the Royal Rumble match later in the month, we now have a report that states that WWE are open to the idea of a similar move in the Men's Rumble match. WrestleVotes would take to Twitter this week to state that WWE are set to try and make an unexpected appearance happen, with them revealing, "Had more than one source this weekend, without me directly asking, state they believe WWE will try for an unexpected Forbidden Door entrance for the Men's Royal Rumble. Personally, I'm skeptical it happens, but I can confirm WWE at least is open to the idea, which is exciting enough." If you look at all the options of former WWE superstars that are signed to another promotion that would also be big enough for such a moment, and more importantly would want to do it, it leaves just one name in my opinion, that being Chris Jericho. Let's not forget that Jericho did recently appear on Stone Cold's Broken Skull Sessions on the WWE Network and Peacock, even discussing the champion's time in AEW, so it's not too far-fetched to think that both sides would be open to a Rumble appearance. Since the report, Jericho's name has been speculated by many on social media as the right fit, although WWE Hall of Famer Booker T doesn't think it would work out, and he would say this on his Hall of Fame podcast. "Let's think about this for a second. Jericho's ass may be booed out of the building, coming into a WWE arena. We don't know what would happen. We do not know what's going to happen if something like that was to happen right now. I would not want to test the waters on something like that right now, me personally." Out of the other options, we know that Bryan Danielson has a good relationship with his former employer, although I think it's safe to rule out the likes of CM Punk and Jon Moxley. Outside of former main eventers, perhaps WWE could move for somebody like Zack Ryder, who currently wrestles for Impact, GCW and NWA as Matt Cardona. Whilst many think that WWE may not want to work with AEW after recent jabs on screen, let's remember that Roman Reigns' current t-shirt is of course a dig at CM Punk. But with that said, let me know what you think. Which former WWE superstar that is signed to another company, whether it be AEW, Impact or somewhere else, do you think could appear in the Royal Rumble? Let me know in the comments down below. And before you go, make sure you check out my video where I discuss 12 of the most obscure WWE appearances by AEW wrestlers.